Apple has finally started rolling out the stable build of iOS 13 to all iPhones released after the iPhone 6s, bringing a number of cool new features and settings to older devices. Now, we have already talked about some of the most interesting features coming in iOS 13 in a recent video, so you should check that out if you haven't already. And in this video, we are going to talk about a couple of important settings that you should change as soon as you get the update on your phone. Hey guys, this is Abhijit from GT and let's get right to it, shall we? To kick things off, let's first talk about the all new dark mode, which is arguably one of the most requested features that's finally making its way to the iOS devices. Now, I'm sure you already know how to turn it on, but if you don't, then there are two simple ways. You can either head over to the display settings and select dark from under the appearance option, or you can long press the brightness slider in the control center to access the toggle. But did you know that there's a third, much easier way to toggle the dark mode? Yes, that's right. iOS 13 lets you add a dedicated dark mode toggle in the control center, using which you can change the theme in no time. Do so, head over to the settings app and select control center. Here tap on customize controls and in the following screen tap on the plus icon. And with just that, you should now see a simple dark mode toggle right within the control center. Convenient, right? Next up, let's talk about the cellular data. Now, Apple has included a couple of different settings to give you more control over cellular data usage. You can find the first one within the iTunes and App Store settings, which will allow you to download apps over 200 MB in size over cellular data. To turn it on, select the App Downloads option and then tap on Always Allow in the following screen. And with just that, you'll now be able to download large apps using mobile data. Now, if you don't have an unlimited data plan, I'd suggest staying away from the setting we just talked about. Instead, you should check out these two settings that will help you save on mobile data. In the same menu, you will find the automatic downloads option, and for some reason, all the automatic downloads are turned on by default, which means that your phone will automatically download any app or music updates as soon as they are available, and that could potentially exhaust your entire bandwidth if you're on cellular data. So ideally, you should turn off automatic download. To do so, just tap on the toggles next to music, apps, and app updates, and then tap on the toggle next to automatic downloads under the mobile data section. Simple, isn't it? Now, there's another handy setting you should change if you want to make sure none of your data is being wasted. This setting called Wi-Fi Assist can be found within the cellular option in the settings menu. Just tap on the toggle next to it to disable it and you're good to go. If you aren't familiar with it, the Wi-Fi Assist feature essentially makes your iPhone switch over to mobile data when the Wi-Fi connection is spotty. This could result in you unwittingly using all your mobile data bandwidth while thinking that you're connected to Wi-Fi. So it's best to just turn it off. Enough about data though, now let's take a look at another useful setting that will help you automatically silence calls from unknown numbers. To turn it on, head into the settings app and then select phone. Then scroll all the way down and tap on the toggle next to silence unknown callers option. And you're done. Now every time you receive calls from an unknown number, your phone will make use of Siri's AI capabilities to identify the number from your contacts, mail and messages. If it doesn't find the number anywhere, your phone will be silenced automatically and the call will be diverted directly to voicemail. Pretty handy, right? Speaking of Siri, isn't it annoying when the voice assistant pronounces your name incorrectly? Well, on iOS 13, you can make sure that doesn't happen ever again. Yep, that's right. You can now train Siri to pronounce your name properly. To do so, bring up Siri and say learn to pronounce followed by your name. Siri will then ask you to say it, and after you do, it will give you a couple of different options to choose from.
Alijit. Abhijit. 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 Abhijit.
Select the best one out of the lot and Siri will then remember that pronunciation for all following conversations. Now, to round things off, let's talk about a setting that will make sure your iPhone's battery ages well and lasts more charging cycles. The setting can be found within the battery health option in the battery settings, and you can enable it by tapping on the toggle next to optimized battery charging. Once it's turned on, your phone will analyze your daily usage patterns and charge your phone only up till 80% until you need to use your phone. So, for instance, if you put your phone on charge when you go to bed at night, the phone will charge slowly up to 80% and then stay there until it's time for you to wake up. Based on your sleeping schedule, the phone will then charge the battery all the way up to 100% right before the time you usually pick up your phone every day. So that wraps it up for this video on iOS 13. Make sure you change all these settings the moment you get that update on your phone. And don't forget to hit the like button below this video if you learned something new today. This is Abhijeet signing off, and I'll see you guys in the next one.